The mother who lost her son after he drank liquid meth from a beer can says she forgives the man responsible for his death. Himatjit Jimmy Kahlon was found guilty of the manslaughter of Aiden Sagala at the High Court in Auckland today. Reporter Yvonne Tahana was in court.
Relief for the Sagala whānau. After a speedy 8-day trial, it took the jury just 2 hours to reach a verdict.
On charge one, the charge of manslaughter, do you find the defendant Himatjit Singh Kahlon guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Kahlon was Aiden Sangala's team leader at Fonterra. He'd given the 21-year-old a slab of honey bear beer, which contained a can filled with liquid methamphetamine.
He did what many of us do every day at the end of the week or whatever, had a drink of beer and presumed it was beer, innocently.
Police discovered that Kahlon was helping a friend who was already pled guilty to drugs charges with an illicit importation business. The pair working in this Manukau warehouse to evaporate water out of some of these cans, leaving behind meth crystals.
Yeah, lots of chemicals and what appeared to be methamphetamine just everywhere.
700 kilograms of meth and a little over 2 kgs of cocaine was found. Kahlon was also found guilty of possessing meth for supply, but not guilty of a cocaine charge.
We're seeing some pretty dramatic innovation around bringing drugs into the country, and that's deeply disturbing.
The Crown's case on the manslaughter charge was that Kahlon had a duty to ensure no one was harmed from the dangerous cans which he was responsible for.
Sometimes I'm angry because we need good people. They fight for the justice, for importing the unknowing things in a country, affecting our younger generation, affecting your family and my family.
My son, I can't get it back. He's a good kid. He look after us. He look after me and my husband.
Aiden's mother saying her son would remain cherished, a gracious offer to Kahlon too.
I forgive him, his family. Him, the one he was offered the beer, I forgive him. Only God knows my heart.
And something beautiful for this family, a new mokopuna, 11 weeks old, named for an uncle, no longer here.
An amazing attitude of forgiveness from the family there, Yvonne. The trial this week was, of course, centred on the tragic death, but there was a lot of meth in that warehouse. Is there more to learn here?
Well, that's right, Simon. The scale of this concealment was massive. 700 kilograms in that haphazard, messy warehouse was worth $80 million. And Kahlon was working with 24,000 cans. When cops raided that warehouse in March 2023, they only found 106 of those honey bear beer cans to contain liquid methamphetamine. But of course, as we now know, it was everywhere. It was on the floor, it was in buckets, it was at every conceivable stage of the evaporation process. And they may not have found it. This is the horribly sad thing. They may not have found it without that tragic death of Aiden Sagala. Another really unusual part of this case is that Kahlon and the other man, who we can't name because he has suppression, they are both considered to be upstanding members of their communities. And indeed, during the trial, Kahlon was described as kind and generous. And when I spoke to one officer about what drives this type of criminal behaviour, he said two things: greed, and the second thing, the massive amounts of money to be made in New Zealand in the meth trade.
Tēnā koe, Yvonne. Thank you.